Amen. Now that I've stood up, maybe I should just sit down that way. Praise God. All that he said, you wouldn't know whether or not all that he said is truly deserving of that honor. But I truly thank God for this opportunity. It is a pleasure to be back in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen, amen, amen. And he gave us traveling grace.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus.
We stopped over in Columbus, Mississippi yesterday evening and witnessed our cousin's daughter's wedding, Pastor Ron Houston. And we got up early this morning.
Yes, Lord.
Now, I need to tell you, it was a great drive from New Orleans to Columbus.
Yeah.
But even a greater drive from Columbus to
Birmingham.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. For us to give honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the author and finisher of our faith. Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And of course, to our friend, our brother, a good mentor, a good teacher, love him to death. Praise God. I haven't been knowing him that long, but praise God, it seemed like a lifetime.
Amen.
All right. Yeah. And I wouldn't trade that for nothing in this world.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. And that is, of course, your esteemed pastor, Pastor Fred Harris.
Amen.
Junior, is that right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Of course, to my other brothers of the gospel, we thank God for them and to all officers and as well as members of this church. And
amen.
Of course, last but not least, I could not come up and sit down without introducing again my darling wife.
Amen.
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 It's a great help in the ministry.
My God.
Great God. A great encourager. Amen. My biggest fan.
Amen.
I thank God for her.
Amen.
As we come before you this day with the word from God, and I do believe it is, because I praise God, I look for confirmation.
Amen.
What God is going to share with us, allow us to share with you today. And Pastor Harris asked me that I needed more time in the back, and I'm a firm believer. I don't have it when I walk in the door.
Amen. Mm-hmm. All right.
I'm not going to get it.
Amen.
And plus, I like being out here when things are rolling.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
When I come out, I can just start rolling with it and allow us to go higher in the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Truly, it's a great blessing and a privilege to be with you. And when I look for confirmation what God has to say for us, I listen to it in songs, whether it be on the radio as we're traveling, through the conversation that my wife and I have, and thank God that we have some wonderful spiritual conversation on the road. And then once I get to the church, I'm still looking at it. And then
amen.
God allow me to become comfortable in what we're going to share with you, because I believe you came to hear from the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Yes,
sir.
Amen. To hear from the Lord. So I look for confirmation. And as I was sitting there, and I listened to the words of the song that was sung, and I'm on the battlefield.
Yeah.
For the Lord.
Yeah.
For my Lord. And then his grace was upon me, and Bible in my hand.
Yeah.
He healed my wounded spirit.
Yes, yes.
Jesus is my rock.
Yeah.
Sword and shield. He's my will in the middle of a wheel.
Yes.
And praise God, as the pastor came and he began to say, I need you.
Yeah.
Yes.
And finally he closed it out with holy, holy.
Holy, holy.
God in three persons.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Truly we thank God. Let us ask God bless us for what we're about to share with you today.
Yeah.
Our Father and our God, it's again that we come before that presence with praise and thanksgiving in our heart. Truly, Father, we're not worthy of this day, a day that we've never seen, nor shall we ever see again. But Father, at this time, in this place, we're going to take the time to give you praise, give you honor, and give you glory.
Yes.
Why? Because you're worthy of all.
Amen.
And Father, we just thank you for allowing us to come before your people this day. We pray, Father God, that we allow self to be removed.
Yes.
Yeah.
Father God, and allow your spirit to enter and proceed out so that all that we say and do will be pleasing in thy sight, that someone would be encouraged, someone would be inspired to go out and tell somebody that Jesus Christ is
blessed.
Amen.
Father, we thank you
thank
and we
you.
Praise you
thank
in the mighty name of Jesus.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Do you believe that Jesus' grace is still amazing?
Amen. Amen.
Don't you know it's only by the grace of God that we're here today?
Yeah. Yeah.
And praise God, as I think about that, I'm reminded, it's not the message, but I'm reminded of a sermon we did some years ago in Tucson, Arizona. The gravity of grace. And let me just throw a plug right there, if you don't mind. And what I'm talking about is you can envision an astronaut out in space. And don't you know when an astronaut move away from that ship, there's a cord or rope that is tied to him, and there's a reason for that.
That's right.
So when that astronaut get too far away from the ship, it tugs. Mm-hmm. Let him know that he's gone. As far as you can go.
All right.
What are you saying, Reverend Washington? Great question that you've asked. That is grace.
Yeah.
That is the gravity of grace. Because I'm here to tell you, if that card is severed, then an astronaut is something to go out into our abyss.
That's right.
And never be seen again. But we thank God for the gravity of grace. But when we get too far out, what do you do?
Thank you.
Thank God for the gravity of grace. I just thought I'd just throw that out there.
My Lord.
You don't mind, do you?
Nah.
Praise God. And you know, how many of you are familiar with technology? Of course, we all are. And we know that, praise God, in the world that we live in now, technology is the way to go.
All right.
Amen.
Praise God. But before we get into our message, let me just share something with you. In 1982, I was on my way back from Tucson, Arizona, which I was in the military for 26 years, retired out there. But I was on my way back home for whatever reason, and I left my Bible. Praise God, you left it. I left my Bible in Tucson, and praise God, and I wasn't preaching then, but nevertheless, I was called.
Amen.
To proclaim the word of God. Well, you wasn't preaching, Reverend Washington. You're absolutely right. Everybody that is called out of darkness into the marvelous light has a testimony to
that's
say.
Right. That's right.
Nevertheless, I came out and my friend that is in Alexandria, Louisiana, my pastor brother, I called him. I said, hey, bro, I need a Bible. So he loaned me one of his. That was in 1982. And when I opened it inside of that Bible, I saw a poem. And God knows that as we begin to search the scripture and bring a word to you, I look for that Bible and I can't find it.
Mama.
So I called my friend in Alexandria a few days ago and I said, hey, brother, do you remember? And lo and behold, the brother got a photographic memory.
Yeah.
He began to quote. He said, if you don't mind, let me just share with you. Don't mind.
Amen.
Yeah, go right ahead.
He said, our name, you got it from your father. It was the best he had to give. And right gladly he bestowed it. It's yours while you live. You may lose the watch he gave you, and another you may claim. But he gave you another, and you may claim. But remember when you're tempted to be careful of his name.
Mama.
It was fair the day you got it, and it were the name to bear. When he took it from his father, there was no dishonor there. Through the years, he proudly wore it. To his father, he was true. And that name was clean and spotless when he passed it on to you.
My Lord.
Oh, there's much that he gave that he valued not at all. He has watched you break your playthings in the days when you were small. You lost the watch he gave you, and you wasted much the same. But you never hurt your father. If you're careful with his name, it is yours to wear forever.
Wow.
Yours to wear the while you live.
All right, now.
Yours to have some distant morning another boy to give.
Wow.
And you'll smile, as did your father, with a smile that all can share. If a clean name and a good name, you're giving him to wear.
All right.
Well, why did you come with that, Reverend Washington? Praise God. As we lift a thought from the scripture that my brother read this morning, praise God, you look at Matthew chapter 1, and he read for your hearing verses 18 through 25. Mm-hmm. But there's a focus verse I want you to pay attention to, and that is verse 21. And it says, and she, praise God,
all right,
and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sin. Is that right?
Yes.
Is that what the Word of God says?
Amen.
Yes. Amen. But let's look at Philippians 2, 9 through 11. And wherefore God also has highly exalted him.
Yeah.
And given him a name which is above every name.
Yeah.
That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of things in heaven and things in earth and things under the earth.
Uh-huh.
And verse 11. And that every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. What's in a name?
Wow.
There's one thing in our lives, praise God, that we have no control over, a little control over, and that's our name.
Uh-huh.
All right.
We are given names by our parents before we even knew who we were.
Mm-hmm.
Some of us was named for our parents. As in the case of a boy who was named for his father, it must go through life carrying the title Junior behind his name. This can create all kinds of psychological problems for the boy in his attempt to live up to the name of his father, or in some sad case, to live down the name.
That's right.
Some of us, praise God, was named for a Bible character, a movie, or a television personality.
Uh-huh.
The question is, what does your name mean?
Wow.
What is your name? Jews, praise God, was very careful in choosing the name of a baby. They gave it very much thought. They chose a name for a baby, usually for his meaning to God.
Very careful.
In this morning text, say this morning text.
This morning text.
In the first chapter of Matthew, we find the story of how God himself named the child.
Name.
God named this child. God would not be the naming of this child to a man. This child was so unique, his mission so compelling, his birth so unusual, his gifts so amazing, and his wisdom so profound.
Mama.
That God himself had to name the child.
So here's how
God orchestrated this thing.
Amen.
God, first of all, he got to get that man mind right. Praise God. So God had to dispatch an angel, praise God, to in a dream to Joseph to explain to him about the child.
Amen.
We know, praise God, brothers, our wife come up and say we're pregnant. Praise God, and you know that you didn't have nothing to do with that. Praise God, that's going to cause you some concern. But see, Jesus in his wisdom knew that he had to first go and talk to Joseph. Because you're dealing with a mortal man.
And praise God,
no matter what Mary said, Joseph said, well, hey, I haven't touched
you. That's right.
How can this thing be? Praise be to God.
Amen.
God, one step ahead of us, I always praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
God went and spoke to Joseph, and he said, Joseph, the baby in Mary's womb has been conceived by the Holy Ghost. It was conceived by the Holy Ghost.
All right.
Praise God. Mary had not been unfaithful to you.
That's right.
She would give birth to a son, and when Mary gave birth to the son, God said, this is what I want you to do.
Here it is.
I want you to call him Jesus. You see, not only, praise God, did Joseph have nothing to do with the baby, He couldn't even name him. But praise be to God, the working of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
You know, brother, we would have problems with that.
Would have problems.
He said, this baby, praise God, will save God's people from their sins. And then you understand how God works. Well, I don't know why I'm saying this, because this is a Bible-led, Bible-taught church.
Amen.
Bringing things back to you. Remember, you know how we forget about things along the way. Every now and then, somebody has to be behind you.
Yeah.
So, and it's a mysterious and unique way God had decided to come and be with his people. God says, shucks. I need to go down here.
Yeah. All right.
God always had this habit if you know it in your life, are revealing himself to his people in the midst of their cry for deliverance and liberation. Have anybody been there?
Yeah, amen.
Have you ever been on your sick bed?
Yeah.
Have you been in a situation where you couldn't pay your bills?
Yeah. Amen.
Let me just talk about myself.
Yeah.
Praise God. I grew up in a time when things was hard.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
We were still in the cotton field.
Yeah.
There was time when we didn't know what we were going to eat or not.
All right,
for some reason, somehow, food always was
seriously
landed on me. I never went hungry as poor as I was.
Amen.
Let me tell you, that's God working.
Oh, yeah.
God always had this habit of revealing himself in the midst of the cry of deliverance of his people.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Jesus. This is what God did. This is the way God works now.
Yes, he did.
And let me, can I stop and stick a pin? Let me just mention for a second. That's not the message, but it's a point here.
Yeah.
You remember when Peter was in jail?
Uh-huh.
The next day, Peter was on his way to the gallows.
Sure.
But what the children of God did, they hung up on their house.
Yes, sir.
And they began to pray that God would deliver Peter.
Yeah.
Now, let me show you how we are. See, we go and we pray God and we ask for deliverance. And when God delivers us, we're shocked.
Mm-hmm. Why?
Did you ask God? They were praying, a knock came on the door.
All right.
It said, it's I, Peter, and the young lady, what's her name, Rebecca?
Yeah, Tabitha.
Tabitha?
Yeah.
That's right. She said, it's Peter. So she ran and told them, and they said, no, it can't be, he's in jail. Wait a minute, are we praying?
That's right.
That God would deliver him?
Yeah.
Why are we here to knock?
Yeah. All right.
Then let's get him to pray.
Yeah.
Why are we surprised?
Yes,
so what did God do with Moses? He spoke to Moses in a burning bush. Can I offer a little human?
Go ahead.
You know we as black folks, you know, we don't play that. You know, there's a bush that is consumed and it's not burning.
Yeah.
All right. All right, brother.
We would 9 out of 10 get in the wind because something wrong with
it. Amen.
But God spoke to Moses. See, when you're obedient, when you're in tune with God, how he come at you, you know it's him, and you're not afraid. So here God spoke to Moses in the burning
book.
He told him, tell my people, I've heard their cry for deliverance from the Egyptian oppressors.
That's right.
Moses said, you know he's
exactly. He did stuff bad, bad.
What should I tell them?
Yeah.
What if they ask who you are? Moses, Jesus said, tell them that I'm God Almighty.
Forever and forever.
I am that I am. I'm Yahweh, the God of heaven and earth. And let me stop you again.
Stop.
No matter what you think your fallacies are.
All right.
I don't care whether you think you're too short, too tall, too thin, too fat, broke, lot of money, God can use you.
Yeah.
Amen. God can use you.
Amen.
You can show that are downtrodden, that are deformed, so you can see the glory of God.
That's right.
So here Moses, he just stuttered. You know the Bible.
He showed this stuff bad.
That he had a speech.
Badly.
He had a speech impediment.
Yes, sir.
But God said, go. And what did God? I speak for you.
Yes, sir.
But God was up. Look, see, God was up to something new this time. He was. Only a God full of love would leave heaven and come to earth in the form of a man.
All right, amen.
Man, come on. Come down to this mess.
Yeah.
Dealing with those folks.
Dealing with them.
Uh-huh. I have to take on the attribute of a man. I have to be hungered. I have to thirst. And Father, you want? Yes.
Yeah.
I love them.
Go see them.
I need you to go see
them. That's right.
So what did God do? God is three persons. Operating himself in a distinct personality. He comes as his son.
Through
a virgin. Amen.
Right.
Who would expect God to come to earth like a helpless baby?
God,
I wouldn't have.
No.
Not being depressed.
No.
Not being under the tyranny of the Egyptian.
Right.
I want to see a white stallion.
Yeah.
With a great man.
Yeah.
On there. And I want him to come through Egypt.
Yeah.
And I want him to do this.
And no. Yes, sir.
That's
yes, sir.
The way God operates.
Amen. Amen.
That's the way he said we're supposed to operate. In humility.
That's
in
right.
Love.
That's
amen.
Right.
Amen. This was a special birth. Say special birth.
Special birth.
This baby couldn't be just named any old thing.
Amen.
This baby had to have a special name.
Yes.
This baby had to have a unique name. This baby had to have a very meaningful name.
Name.
The baby name had to be Jesus, which means God save or save us.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Jesus came to save his people from their
sins. That's right. Yeah.
God reveals himself when he hears the cry of his people. God heard the cry of countless people.
Yes, he did.
Struggling under the burden of sin.
Yeah.
Now, here they were struggling under the oppression of the Egyptians.
They were.
Let's find, can we fast?
Rewind.
Amen.
Yes,
amen.
Fast one.
Okay, all right.
To the 13th of September.
All right.
That's the day.
That's right.
2015.
All right.
We are suffering under the burden of sin.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Amen.
Right.
Amen.
Let me tell you, look here. This is what God did. God has sent his prophets, priests, and kings.
Joe did.
God has sent Moses.
Joe
he
did.
Has sent Joshua.
Right.
He has sent Elijah.
Right.
He has sent Isaiah. He has sent Jeremiah. He has sent David and Solomon, but none of these had the power
none of
to save us from sin.
Wow.
Amen.
Wow.
Amen.
Wow.
Amen.
And is he that is in us?
Yeah.
And he that is against us, and no weapon formed against us shall prosper.
That's right.
Look what you say, bro. I'm saying me and God can defeat any army.
Yeah.
Any army.
Amen. Yeah.
You cannot even have you can't even count the numbers that can come up against God and win.
That's right. Right.
None.
None.
But now, this is what God did. He sprung into action. Oh, no, he wasn't like Superman. He sprung into action. God himself. God said, you know, prophet, all these folks, good soldiers. Good for soldiers.
Good soldiers.
Good for soldiers. Let me throw Ruth and Naomi in there, too, if you don't mind. But wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now, I got to go down here myself.
Amen.
Now, I got to go down here. But see, it just ain't working.
Amen. All right.
I need to go down myself.
All right.
Amen.
So God sent his only begotten son,
yeah,
Jesus the Christ.
All right, God.
Why? Then I said, what's in the name? Well, what's in the name of Jesus? They tell me there's salvation.
Mm. Yeah, salvation.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah.
Why? For he saved people from sin.
Yeah.
Sin, praise God, is the root cause of all trouble.
That's right.
I'm going to give you something.
That's it.
Because I know it's not here, but I'm just throwing something out. Strife, it's not in this church. Confusion, it's not in here.
Wow.
Lying, it's not in here. Backbiting, it's not in here. And all those other things that he used to be said, I know it's not in the word of faith.
All right, yeah. All right,
you know, so all right, man. And even my church, my whole church, that stuff is there. Amen.
Wow.
So God looked at all of that. Now, he did not look past word of faith because there's none of that stuff here. But he looked at those other churches to go to my church and say, I need to send somebody down there.
My God.
They need to be saved from their sin.
Amen.
What is sin? Sin is the willful disobedience of God. Sins occur when people decide to live independently of God. In other words, my way.
Yes, sir.
It's my thing.
All right.
You know, I do what I want.
That's right.
You know.
All right.
You know how it is. Just the way I do it.
Yeah.
But see, that's when we allow sin to interfere.
That's right.
That's what sin really is. It is designed to live by our own rules.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
If you see a person like that, just start living together. You know, when you see a person you like, it's marriage. The Bible talks about marriage. Well, I like it, you know. Got it going on. Let's just move in. Why bother with marriage license? If you're married but see someone else who looks better than you, just start having a family with them.
All right, now.
You know, I'm married to a beautiful woman. You know, I look so good at her. Praise God. Sin is the desire to make our own decision. It's the desire to lean on our own understanding. Yet we ignore God from time and time.
We do that.
We live lives as though God do not exist.
Yeah.
We come here every Sunday. We have Bible study.
Yeah.
And you come here every Wednesday. Oh, how I love Jesus.
Uh-huh.
And then we go out the door and live any kind of way.
Wow.
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 Uh-huh.
I'm not sitting next to her.
Yeah.
I can't stand
him. Amen.
I don't like him.
Yeah.
See how he's looking at my wife? If I can't come to the church,
amen,
and get relief from
yeah.
that mess,
yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
I'm going to tell you what's out there is in here.
All right.
Amen.
So we're
amen.
Just folks.
Amen.
Trying to live saved lives.
That's right.
But there's two people that exist in a church. Can I tell you who they are?
Amen.
They are the same in a service.
That's right.
That's what's in the church. And praise God, you need a boat. What you mean you need a boat? Mm-hmm. Well, you need the same folks in here to help the sinner to get saved.
To get saved.
And the sinners are in here to make sure the same folks stay saved. I guess that's the way it goes because they still, they've been in the church ever since.
They sure are, John. They sure are.
Yes,
sir.
Yeah,
that's right.
Praise God.
Oh, you have one.
We pay lip service to him.
Yeah. Here it is.
We ignore God. We don't come out to worship God in his house. When he said we're there two or three gathered. I heard the brother here this morning. You know, praise God. And he took it right out of my page. That's okay. I don't care if you came with three or four in here. God called me here to preach.
Amen.
I'm a preacher. Amen. Yes.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying? Amen. And the Bible says there's a reason for these words in that Bible.
Yes, sir.
They're not just there.
That's
amen.
Right.
When he said, with a two or three gathered in his name, touching and agreeing, he'd be in the midst. Yes. And where Jesus is, there's deliverance.
Yes, yes. Amen.
And where Jesus is, praise God, there's healing.
Yeah.
Sin separates us from God. Not only does it separate us from God, and I'm not going to be with you too much longer, sin separates us from each other.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Even in the church.
Amen.
Take the way we get along with
yes.
each other. It is sin when we come into the house of God and hold a grudge against somebody.
Amen.
Amen.
That's sin.
Amen.
It is sin when we say things to people that is hurtful, mm-hmm. that hurt their feelings,
right.
that have cut them to the quill.
Right.
That's sin.
Right.
That ain't cute. If we can't say a kind word, you know, my mama used to tell me, you can't say something nice, keep what she said it in so many, but she was nice. Don't keep your mouth closed.
Yeah, amen.
You can't say something nice, don't say anything
amen.
At all. If we can't say a kind word, keep silent.
Amen. That's right.
Keep silent. If we can't build somebody up, don't tell them.
Amen.
It's sin when you're too busy to reach out. A helping hand to somebody fortunate somebody.
That's
what's in the name?
What's it?
There is salvation in the name of Jesus. All you have to do is call on Jesus.
All right.
Praise God. All you have to do is believe on the name which is above every name, and you shall be saved.
Yeah.
You know, that's the reason why we sang that song, and I'm not going to try. Praise God, I was listening to Ranch Allen and Kirk Frank, and it said something about the name
yeah.
of Jesus.
That's right.
It is the sweetest name I know.
That's right.
Oh, how I love the name Jesus.
Yeah.
It's the sweetest thing I know.
Yeah.
Some people say I'm crazy,
he's
but I can't explain the
all
power
right.
that I feel
yeah.
when I call your name.
Yeah. yeah.
Say it just like fire. Shut up in my bones. And it said, go on and say, it's the Holy Ghost moving. And it just won't leave me alone.
All right.
Say, it's sweeter
yeah.
than honey.
Yeah.
Than honey gold.
Yeah.
And then it tells me, I can feel
yeah.
the Holy Ghost
yeah.
moving. And it won't leave me alone.
Thank
at
it,
the name of Jesus,
yes,
every knee
yeah.
has got to bow. So you don't have to wait till the fire comes.
That's right.
You come on and shout and praise unto him. And
that's right.
Then at the end of that song, it says, do it now. What's in the name of Jesus?
All right.
There's preservation in that name.
Amen.
Jesus don't save you and leave you to fend for yourself. He is with you to keep you from falling.
Thank you, Lord.
He's a present help in situations. We are kept by his divine power.
Oh, man.
He can keep us from the power and the stain of sin.
That's right.
Why? In the name of Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
They said the devil must flee.
Yeah.
If Jesus can save us, then I need to tell you that he's able to keep us.
Yeah.
There is preservation in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
He will keep you day by day.
So will
it's
do.
Like that gravity of grace that we talked
yeah,
about.
Yeah, yeah,
praise
yeah.
God in your weakness. He's your strength.
Yeah.
Yeah.
In your trials. He's your all.
Thank you, Master.
Yeah.
He will be near you all day long.
Thank
Paul
you.
Say he's as close as my breath to myself.
Yeah.
Well, he will keep your heart.
Yeah.
And he will keep your hand.
Yeah.
He will keep your tongue to praise his name.
Yeah. Yeah.
He will keep your soul. He will keep you all the way.
Yes, sir.
What's in a name, there's preservation in the name.
In the name.
And I'm not going to be with you too much longer. I just have a few more points to bring.
Take
your time, mind me bring those points. Do your work.
Go right, baby. Go right.
There's not only salvation, and there's not only preservation in that name, but there's glorification in the name of Jesus. How do you know? Well, we know that our lives are incomplete here on earth.
Yes.
We know that we suffer from imperfection
yeah.
of mind, Amen. Body, and spirit.
Yeah. Yeah.
We know that we are frail
yeah.
and as fragile as dust.
Yeah.
We know that we're like the grass in the field.
We're like that.
That passes away on the ground.
That's right.
We know that we're in the midst of dawn that will disappear and be seen no more.
Right, right.
Why? Because the name of Jesus, we have something better in store.
Yes, sir.
Don't you know there's a better life on the other side?
All right.
I hear Paul say that eyes have not seen.
Oh, right.
Ears have not heard.
All right, all right.
Has it entered into the hearts of men that God has in store for him? Why? Because he loves us.
Yeah.
Our
yeah.
salvation is incomplete. What's in the name of Jesus?
All right.
Well, we know that in order to love one another, we must have the love of Christ.
All right.
Yeah.
We know that there's power in the name of Jesus.
That's right.
How do you know that, Reverend Washington? Where did that power come from? You don't mind walking with me for a little while.
Go right ahead,
word John. Of faith.
Come on,
well,
come
on, I see Calvary Cross.
Yeah.
Out down on the hill.
Yeah.
And I know, praise God, that Jesus said, if I be lifted up,
yeah.
I draw all
men
to me. Why? Because there's power
yeah.
in the name
yeah.
of Jesus. There's deliverance
yeah.
in the name of Jesus.
Name,
but you
yeah.
need to understand, yeah. word of faith,
yeah.
on your way to Calvary Cross.
Yeah.
What do you mean, Reverend Washington? I'm saying to everybody, has a cross today.
Yeah.
God. Don't you see Jesus beckoning for us? Don't you see Jesus calling out on us? He said, here I am. Here I am. There's power in my name.
Yeah.
And I need to let you know, word of faith, on your way to Calvary Hills, don't you know there's going to be some struggles along the way?
Yes, sir.
Don't you know there's going to be some higher heights
yeah,
and lower lows,
yeah.
lower valleys in the Lord?
Yeah.
But nevertheless, I'm here to tell you that Jordan River must be crossed.
Yes.
Jordan River must be crossed.
Yeah.
I'm here to tell you there's shock in the water.
Yeah.
Praise God. One of those shock that's the backbiters.
Yes.
There's some liars.
Yeah.
There's the one that's going to try to knock you down. To the ground.
Yeah.
I'm so thankful that Donnie McPherson said, we fall down,
yeah.
but we get up,
yeah.
we get up in the name of Jesus.
Right.
Why? Because Calvary Cross
yeah.
is
yeah.
our destination.
Yeah.
Why? Because there is Christ. I see him now,
yeah.
and he's beckoning for us. But I'm here to tell you, sometimes you're going to fall along the way.
Yeah.
But be not discouraged.
Yeah.
Why? Because there's going to be somebody, God is going to see it, that's going to help you along the
yeah.
way. Don't you know we're not in this race by ourselves?
Yeah.
We have encouragement of each other.
That's
we have inspiration of one another
that's right.
in Christ.
Yeah.
Why? Because we all want to make it in.
Yeah.
But there is Calvary Cross. I see him now.
I see
him. I see him now.
I see him.
I see him now.
Yeah.
They done laid him down on that old hard ground.
Yeah.
Praise God, I'm looking.
Yeah.
They put a nail in his left hand.
Yeah.
I can only see that the Son of God must have smiled and said, that nail is for the Father.
Yeah.
Praise God, I'm still looking. They put a nail in his right hand.
All
right. I
can
only imagine that Jesus must have smiled again and said, that nail is for the Son.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Talk,
oh, my God. I see them put spikes in his feet, and they raised him up. Praise God, but those spikes were for the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Praise God. And don't you know those that were standing along the way, they must have thought that was the end.
Yeah.
That was just a condition of, that wasn't the conclusion of the condition.
All right.
What do you mean? After they lifted him up, they tell me that it got dark.
Yeah.
They tell me that it got dark.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And man can understand.
Yeah.
And somebody said he must have been the Son of God.
Yeah.
That's okay. I'm here to tell you, when your naysayers think they got you,
all right,
be encouraged. Jesus is on the way,
yeah,
and he's gonna lift you up. What do you mean? You see, they buried him,
yeah,
in a borrow too.
Yeah.
And we know anything that the borrow, you got to
get
God. Oh, come mercy. They tell me, and I wasn't there, and I'm on my way home. I wasn't there. They tell me he stayed there all night Friday.
Yes,
I don't know whether it was Friday, but my faith tells me he stayed there.
Yes.
Praise God, they say he stayed there all day Saturday and all night Saturday night. Again, I wasn't there,
yes,
but my faith tells me it happened. Oh, something happened. Something happened. Something happened. Something happened.
Yes.
What did he do? What did he do? Praise God, he got up.
Yeah.
He got up.
Yeah.
He got up.
Yeah.
He got up.
Yeah.
He wasn't through then.
Yeah.
He had to lead him with the word.
Yeah.
He said, all power.
Yeah.
All power. All power,
yeah,
in my name. That's why I can call on the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
Yeah.
Well, there's something.
Yeah.
There's something,
yes,
about the name,
yes,
of Jesus. There's power, there's deliverance,
yes,
there's salvation.
Yes.
Why? Because he's my all,
yes,
and all.
Yes.
I remember it, I'm on my way when that song says, sign me up.
Yes.
To believe, write my name,
yes,
on the road.
Yes.
Why? Because I can say,
yes, yes, sir.
Lord,
yes, sir.
Listen to you. Why? Because there's something in the name,
yes,
and his name is Jesus.
Yes.
His name is Jesus.
Yes.
God bless you,
yes,
and God keep you.
Yes.
There's something in the name. There's something in the name.
Oh, yes.
We have a great pastor.
Amen.
Amen.
Ray Harris Jr.
Amen.
But there's something in the name,
yeah,
of Jesus. I don't care how well he preaches.
That's right.
I don't care how he can lay hands and heal.
Said,
but he only can do it because of the power,
yeah,
yes, sir, yes, sir,
of the name of Jesus.
Right.
Yeah. Red Harry can't do nothing.
Yeah.
It's the power.
Yes, sir.
And the power comes from Jesus.
Yeah. Yeah.
He can perform, he can preach. Before he can lay hands, he got to call the name.
Yeah.
He got to call the name. And
yeah,
his name is Jesus.
Yeah.
His name,
all right,
is Jesus.
Come on.
That's good. God bless you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You know, I'm not a singer, but there's a song that says, praise God, when I find myself weary and worn,
mm-hmm,
I realize when my strength comes where I,
yeah,
said, I will trust.
All right.
Yeah. In the Lord, I will trust. In the Lord, I will trust. In the Lord, until I.
my Christian experience of my life.
I want to stay on and in me.
Challenging and very thought-provoking message.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
Dr. Washington shares with us.
Amen.
On today. And you're right, Charlie. Jews were very specific and very particular about the naming of their children. If you recall the incident regarding John the Baptist, Elizabeth came in and suggesting a name for him. And of course, you know, Zachariah hadn't had a son, and the elderly man, so I'm assuming that he probably would have named him Zach Jr. But God locked his mouth up.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
He couldn't speak.
Uh-huh.
So when Elizabeth went to him and said, Zach, what do you think we ought to name? He said, bring me a pen and paper. And he wrote down the name. His name shall be John. And immediately after that, God unlocked his mouth. I can tell you that God can lock up the mouth.
Yeah.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen. He can do that.
Yes, sir.
Amen. He is going to have his will and his way. He ought to pray constantly, as Jesus said, not my will, but thy will be done.
Amen.
Thy will be done on earth.
Yes, sir.
As it is in heaven. Synonymous is as significant, as the names are, it is imperative and important. I found out some years ago what my name means.
Mm-hmm.
And it is significant. Fred means ruler.
Mm-hmm.
Fred means ruler. My middle name, James, means peace. Amen.
Amen.
So characteristics of my name, I mean, I think it's fitting. The Lord made me a peaceful ruler.
Amen.
A ruler who is peaceful.
Amen.
Amen. So those names were very, very, very important in biblical time. His name brings salvation. That's what he told us. Now, this is the very thing which separated us from God.
Uh-huh.
It separated us from God. We couldn't call up on him. We couldn't pray to him. And certainly we wouldn't be saved without the name of Jesus.
Amen. That's right.
I'm really glad that he told Joseph, you can't name him. Amen. He would not let Joseph name him. Now, very happy that he cleared up for us, you know, some of our inhibitions, because if it hadn't been us, brethren, in a similar situation.
Uh-huh.
So the man said, well, I got a baby coming.
Uh-huh.
We just married. Or matter of fact, we ain't married, we just engaged.
Uh-huh.
And you got one on the way already. God would have had to intervene in that.
Amen.
Amen. Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
Yeah, he's not, yeah. Yeah, he'd have to intervene in that.
Amen.
God, you gonna have, if this gonna work out, you better get in.
Amen.
So he did just that. He said that sin not only separates us from God, but it also separates us from each other.
Amen.
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 Uh-huh.
Amen.
And you can see what's going on in our world now, Dr. William, that sin is separating us.
Amen. Amen.
Not just by ethnicity, amen, but culturally
culture.
Separated.
Amen. Amen, Pastor. Amen.
Charlie, not long ago, someone was asking me a question about why we are the way we are. I said we're that way because we're being sold a culture. You've been disenfranchised and your culture has been robbed.
Yes.
You've been robbed of your culture. You wonder why you want to wear this outfit, that outfit. You want to wear Italian and you want to wear some of these other name brand things because you don't have your own culture.
Amen.
While we're always consuming and not actually purchasing or selling buying someone else's culture. Even the suit I like to wear, the Carabelli, it is an Italian cut suit, but I'm not Italian.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. And so we're learning a lot. Sin separates us culturally. It separates us ethnically. This name of Jesus also operates in preservation. Preservation. I find it a delight and a pleasure to know that God keeps me day by day.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
And it doesn't matter, Sister Mac, whether I know it or not.
Amen.
Uh-huh. He makes it rain on the just. Amen. He doesn't care. As well as the unjust. And that's because he's preserving us.
Uh-huh.
He's keeping us. I was preaching from a passage not long ago, Charlie, and I was telling them that people, when they heard Jesus' message, they had opposition. They said, well, he doesn't have letters. Doesn't have letters. And so what authorized him, or what authorization is he using to preach this gospel, to preach with such authority and with what power? He preserves us. He's a very present help.
Amen.
In our times of need. And I don't know a single day that I don't need.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You may be able to come up with one, but I can't think of one moment when I don't need
in
my life. And finally, he said, this name brings us glorification. What a blessing to take something that was worthless, smooth it out, and make it something of value. Amen. Now, all of us were sinners, lost on our way to hell.
Amen.
Amen. But God took us.
Thank you, Jesus.
Cleaned us up.
Thank you, Lord.
And made us vessels.
Ooh, thank you, Jesus.
Of honor. What a privilege it is to be honored by the Lord.
Yes,
Lord. Amen. And I can imagine being in heaven as God goes through heaven parading us around. This is my child. Meet my child. Meet my child. Meet my child. Like we're awards or we're trophies. Amen. What an honor it is. How many of you look to be glorified?
Amen, man.
Share the same place and the same person as just God. Amen.
Amen.
Glorification is really certain hours. We can enjoy that. Amen. Thank you, Dr. Washington. Give the Lord a hand clap if you will.
Amen.
I know Westwego is not hurting for preaching.
Amen.
Amen. Because Reverend Washington knows how to cut it straight.
Amen.
Amen.
Basically, let me put it to you in Elizabethan terms, rightly divide the word of truth. You need to cut it straight. Amen. You know how a seamstress does. If he makes a mistake on a piece of fabric, that piece of fabric sometimes can be lost. And another piece needs to be selected.
Amen.
But when you get somebody who knows what they're doing,
amen,
you can cut the fabric straight. Amen. According to his measurement. Thank you so much, one and all. Now listen, we're going to retire for this moment. Amen. But we have one other order of business to recruit our service, and that is our altar prayer. I want to thank God today so much for Washington and his wife coming and sharing with us in these services today, for making this trip.
Amen.
Amen. Come and be with us. And we're going to also pray that the Lord bless him in their journey back home.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I want to pray for Dr. Steve Small. He is one of the ministers in our Birmingham conference. He's also the former president of our ministers' conference here in Birmingham. And his wife passed away on last week. And many of you know there are some churches hurting right now.
Amen.
Your church still has a pastor.
Amen.
Amen.
But some churches that are in the area don't have them. Dr. Sims has moved on and transitioned.
Amen.
And I knew what I told you about the ambassador when God sends us here. The only time we can go back there is when he calls us.
Amen.
Amen.
And he was called back home.
Amen.
And you have enough time here. Now come on home. Amen. Certainly we want to pray for those. Breaker Church and Dr. pastor, we're going to pray for those churches. We've had several senior pastors who have deceased and moved on within the last few weeks. I want to continue to pray for our church.
Amen.
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 Amen. I think the Lord has done a remarkable job.
Amen.
In these 16 years we've been together. Amen.
Amen.
And we're going to continue to grow both physically and spiritually.
Amen. Amen.
And I'm praying, and I hope that you'll be praying right along with us, that God will give us more skilled people.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm astounded by ministries that can actually do great things without skilled people in skilled positions.
Amen.
And then I'm going to close out with this, you know, our white counterparts, and I'm so happy with this, you know, they never assign a duty or a responsibility to someone who is not trained.
Amen.
Amen.
We have like tendency of trying to put people in places with no training. It's, well, they'll figure it out. Yeah, after they've made enough mistakes.
Amen.
They kind of work their way through it. There's nothing like having people around you who are trained.
Amen.
Amen. I'm praying for that for my ministers, for my deacons, for my trustees. I'm praying that for all of my auxiliary presidents. I'm praying that for all of you who are lay people.
Amen.
You are really Christian, Lord, and be expert at it. Need training.
Amen.
Amen. And don't ever get to the point where you think you've reached your apex.
Amen.
You don't know it all.
Amen.
And as a pastor, I don't know it all.
Amen.
And you ought to be thanking God that you have someone as a pastor who is expert.
Amen.
Amen. Because I don't try to be comparative to anybody, but I don't want to be better at what I do than anybody else either.
Amen.
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 And not to say that I don't want anybody to be trained or to be as good. I'm hoping that what we share will cause you to excel beyond that.
Amen.
But you got to start at master level and work your way up.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Okay, we'll bring that back to you later. Then you'll probably get that on your way to the house.
Amen.
Amen. Our level of training dictates something that we have invested that time, effort, and energy in a position to share as we do. So I'm praying to God that He'll give us more expert people, not just putting people and fitting people in slots with no training.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I think that's the reason why a lot of ministries and auxiliaries fail, is because we just put somebody in a position with no training.
Amen.
And even the Bible very clear about that, that we should never use a novice to pastor. Well, we should never use a novice in pastor. Why you gonna put a novice over the usher boy?
Amen.
Amen.
Or president of the choir.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And I want us to continue to pray for that. I want to pray for all of you who have issues.
Amen.
Concerning sicknesses and illnesses.
Amen.
As we get ready to conclude this service, I want to acknowledge and receive now all of you who have prayer requests and petitions for prayer. At this time, pray for my father. We made a trek towards Pennsylvania this weekend. Well, not this weekend, this week. Amen. And he is not here today, but I'm certainly sure that he's dealing with his loss.
Yes.
Amen.
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 Now, you think about it this way, one of your brothers or sisters passed away.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. Doesn't matter how old they are.
Amen.
It doesn't even matter if you knew they were sick and you were expecting them to die. You just deal with the suddenness of death.
Amen.
And it will affect you as well. Amen.
Amen.
God bless and God keep all that. Any others who desire prayer? Yes.
Deacon Ray Williams and family.
Yeah, you're doing a fine job. We'll keep on praying that you continue the job.
Amen.
Amen. I haven't talked with Bunchy yet, but we are going to connect.
Yes, sir.
Amen. We're going to connect. Will there be another? Is there another? Yes.
Williams family number two.
Not for William. He need prayer too?
All the time. We both do. But Pastor, I ask prayer.
Let me put it this way, Sister Wade. He's of age.
Still need prayer.
Okay, all right.
Amen.
All right, is there another?
I'm asking prayer because I'm having issues, back problems, serious back problems. And they act like they don't want to go away, but he can get rid of them.
Amen. Yeah. Glad you came to church to break the problem. Solved.
Amen.
He better than a masseuse chair.
Amen.
He better than a chiropractor.
Yes, Lord. Amen.
Right as another one. There another one. Pray for some CT and I.
Amen.
I made that inclusive statement. Amen. Pray for us.
Amen.
I think things are developing very well.
Yeah, they won, I told.
Thank you. So much. Thank you, my friend. Thank you so much. Amen.
God is
able. Amen.
Amen. Amen. In name but faith.
Amen. I pray for my niece.
Amen.
She's here again today, but she has kept her word to God.
Yes.
Amen. Amen.
That is not a commitment to me.
Amen.
Or the family.
Amen.
Or to anyone else. She is on a search for God.
Amen.
Amen. And I promise you, God is willing to reveal himself to someone who's looking.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. I pray for my nephew. Mm-hmm. Still haven't made a decision yet.
Amen.
And
amen.
I'm not trying to sing you. I'm just simply saying, if you love your love, to try to pull you in.
Amen.
Amen. Time is all spent. If you're over 12 years old, you can do multiplication pretty good. You can add, subtract, all that kind of, you can write your own name. Yeah, you over. Yeah. You can make a conscious decision. Amen.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
Is there another? Yes.
I'd like to keep our church family in prayer too, Ray.
Amen.
Our whole church. Amen. Amen. We haven't seen Mother Webb.
I talked to her.
Nobody said anything about her yet. Anybody talked to her?
I talked with her, Rip.
All right. All right. Now, what we're going to end up doing here eventually, if she doesn't show up here soon, bombard her.
Amen.
Blow up her phone, her cell phone.
Amen.
Cruise by her house. Go in groves. Amen. Amen. Where are you at? You like that booze mother? Where are you at?
I talked to her the other day, and she said she was feeling pretty good, but it's coming along well.
Yeah, I think she's getting ready for a second surgery is what it is. And so I know it's a one-day thing, but when you talk about the foot, you can get around that.
Mm-hmm. Also, Pastor, add my brother.
Oh,
he's very sick.
Okay.
Again.
All right.
And my mama, too. They just been real sick. Mama hadn't been that long gotten back in town. When she was out of town, she was doing wonderful. Now she's back here, she won't get out to bed again.
All right. Any others? We don't treat this part of the service any less than we do any other part of the service. Amen.
Amen.
If you have time, if you have to go, we understand that. If you have time.
Amen.
Indignify this service by rushing it.
Amen.
Oh yeah, Rip. I got one more. For one of my co-workers, she lost her grandmama on Friday.
Okay.
Tina.
All right. Pray for our ministers.
Amen.
All of them are in school now and training. And so pray that they'll continue their training.
Amen.
Amen. And I know some of the problem may be financial, with dealing with tuition and books. Amen. But God has a way of opening the door.
Amen, Rip.
Reverend Washington talked about time when he was out in the cotton field. Mm-hmm. And just recall how there was always, didn't have a whole lot, but there was always something on the table to eat.
Amen.
How it got there, he doesn't know. He just knows now it was God. But how it happened, it had to be God.
Amen.
You can believe him then, believe him now.
Amen, Rip.
All right. Bow your head for y'all. Eternal, we are so grateful today for this privilege of just worshiping in your name. This week has had its ups and its downs. It has had its turmoils and it has had its trials. But we're grateful for you taking care of us and preserving us through this week. thankful that you gave us a reasonable portion of our health and our strength. Thank you that you gave us the activity of our limbs, that the fingers and toes still work, and the ears and eyes still work. And Lord, we're thankful that you have given us another opportunity to experience you in worship. And we look forward to this time where we can close our minds to this world and focus all of our attention upon thee. First of all, we thank you for Reverend Washington and for your grace in allowing he and his family to come this way to share with us on today in worship. Thank you for caring so much about this church that you cared about him to bring him here safe and sound.
Amen.
And then God, thank you for sending us a word through him on today.
Thank you, Lord.
What is in a name?
Yeah.
We thank you so much for the name of Jesus, because there is no other name given in heaven or among men whereby we must be saved but by the name of Jesus. They can call Fred Harris, but it won't save them.
Amen.
They can call me by my nickname, but it won't save them.
Amen.
But by the authority and power of the name of Jesus, salvation and deliverance has already come.
Yeah.
While we are praying, God, we thank you so much for our sons who share this great work with us. I'm praying for their due diligence in their training, that you'll continue to inspire them so that they can inspire other people.
Amen.
Praying for auxiliary leaders across the board in our church, that they will become inspired to see training.
Amen.
And to improve upon themselves and their particular areas of ministry. Lord, I know that the job they have done thus far has been a commendable job, but all of us can improve.
Amen.
So I'm praying that you bless us to improve. Help us to become more astute and more skilled at our ministries and the gifts and callings that you have placed and given to us in our lives. We're praying for our sick and our shut-in, those members who are not here but are dealing with illnesses and sicknesses in their lives. And I won't sing you like an usher. I'm simply going to say continue to do what you've always done, and that is to be who you are. You're a God who sits on high, but you're a God who takes care of everything.
Thank you, Lord.
The earth is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell therein. And I know that you have done it in the past, and you will continue to do it even now and in the future. We are praying for my father and for many other who have lost loved ones over this week and the past week. My dear friend, Dr. Albert Grant, who has moved on, an accomplished choir director and a voice trainer. Thank God so much for you giving us this gift to the body of Christ and for the utilization of so many churches who have had the distinct pleasure of utilizing his abilities and his talents. We are praying for our church.
Amen.
Amen.
For all of our children and every auxiliary all over, all across the board. Pray that your blessing upon Sister CT and I. Amen. I thank you for what you have done. And I'm praying that you will continue to do as we mesh and mail and mingle and come to an agreement and understanding with each other.
Amen.
Pray for Sister Carl's mom and for her brother. Pray for my dad and for my brother.
Amen.
Amen. Pray for Sister Ware and for all of those who are under the sound of my voice who are dealing with issues but did not share those issues with us. God, we trust that you are sovereign.
Yes.
And that you are controller of the entire universe. We have come to you in humble submission and given you our petitions and requests for prayer. And we just thank you now in advance that you have already heard our petition. And we know if you've heard us, you are doing what we ask of you.
Yes.
We thank you for our children and we thank you for our church. Now bless us, Lord. As we do go forward and do great exploits for thee in the name of Jesus. And to that end, our Father, we pray that when everything is finished and done, when our days are done, when our life is done, when our ministry is done, when our preaching is done, when our singing is done, we can hear a welcome word from thee that they are deserving to be at home in their spot. In their place, that Jesus will come and take them to. It is in the name of our Christ we pray, we ask it all. All hearts that agree, say amen.
Amen.
Now I will leave the final remarks and benediction to our guest on today. How many of you are really held by the word?
Amen.
Amen. Thank God for salvation.
Amen.
Thank God for preservation.
Amen.
But thank God for glorification.
Amen.
Because flesh and blood cannot enter into the kingdom.
Amen.
So we must go through metamorphosis.
Amen.
We have to be changed before we can meet God face to face. And glorification is going to make that happen for us. Again, Dr. Washington, thank you so much.
Let the church say praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen, amen. Time has, I don't like to say well spent, but I love saying been spent well.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. And the final thought, Joseph could not name Jesus because Joseph had nothing to do with Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So just in case, well, why wasn't he? Well, he ain't nothing to do with it.
He had nothing.
Amen.
Absolutely nothing. God bless you, God keep you. We'll be back for 3 o'clock.
Amen.
Amen.
I'll be back.
Amen.
I'll be
back. Amen.
I'll
Amen.
You.
Amen.
Father God, again, we come thank you for this marvelous opportunity that you've given us to come together and to praise and magnify that holy name. And thank you for the word, Father. We pray that someone has been inspired, someone has been encouraged to continue to go on in spite of. Father, we thank you. And Father, as we're about to be dismissed from this place, we pray, Father God, we would never be dismissed from thy sight. And if it be thy will, that we would come together one more time under this roof, we would come praising and magnifying that holy name. For in the name of Jesus, we pray. And let all of God's children say amen.
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 Amen.